y'all. I'm Amber Hoberg, a board-certified psychiatric mental health nurse practitioner. I currently practice with Morningstar Family Medicine and Baptist Health System in San Antonio, Texas. Today, I'll be talking about tardive dyskinesia, or TD, as a chronic disorder that needs to be managed long-term. I will be discussing the AUSTEDO 3-year open-label study. Then we will review video of a real patient's journey with AUSTEDO over 2 years. All patients taking antipsychotic drugs, or APDs, are at risk of TD. For patients taking atypicals, the prevalence is 7%. For those taking typical antipsychotics, the prevalence is 30%. Several factors may contribute to an increased risk of TD. The most important being that the incidence of TD is 6 times higher among older patients. Likewise, higher cumulative exposure to APDs, which is a combination of the dose, length of exposure, and potency of the medication, is a key consideration. We're starting to gain a better understanding of how TD can contribute to functional disability. In an online survey, 269 patients with TD were asked to rate the impact of TD across social, psychological, physical, and vocational domains. They assigned ratings of 1, representing the least impact, to 5, representing the most impact. 3 out of 4 patients in the survey selected 4 or higher on 1 or more domains, which indicates a severe impact due to their TD. TD has an impact on management of the patient's underlying psychiatric disorder. I like this visual because it's helpful to think of the underlying mental health condition as though TD was a cracked foundation below it. The same study that asked patients to rate the impact of TD also revealed that 48% of patients skipped or reduced their antipsychotic, and 39% stopped taking it altogether. In addition, some patients discontinued their appointments with the prescribing physician or even advised someone else not to take their antipsychotic medication. TD is chronic and disabling, so I'm always considering the underlying mental health disorder when managing patients. I use the Abnormal Involuntary Movement Scale, or AIMS, to screen for movements and monitor patients with TD at every clinical encounter. In addition, an assessment of the impact of TD is always part of my follow-up. The American Psychiatric Association recommends VMAT2 inhibitors for moderate to severe or disabling TD. They also recommend treating even mild TD that has an impact on the patient. Importantly, VMAT2 inhibitors can be taken without modifying a patient's antipsychotic medication or dose. AUSTEDO XR is a VMAT2 inhibitor approved for the treatment of TD in adults. AUSTEDO XR contains an immediate release outer coating and an extended release osmotic tablet core surrounded by a semi-permeable membrane. Right after the patient ingests it, the immediate release outer coating releases approximately 30% of the dosage. At the same time, water diffuses through the membrane, hydrating the tablet core, and the remaining approximately 70% of drug is extruded through a laser drill delivery orifice at a constant rate. Bioequivalence of AUSTEDO XR has been established with AUSTEDO twice daily, or BID, based on pharmacokinetic profile studies. The clinical studies for AUSTEDO were all done with the AUSTEDO BID formulation. This gold line shows a constant rate of delivery of the AUSTEDO XR formulation over 24 hours versus the 2 peaks with the 12 milligram AUSTEDO BID line, which is illustrated in purple. Data support bioequivalence of AUSTEDO XR and AUSTEDO BID across the full clinical dosing range of AUSTEDO, which is 12 milligrams to 48 milligrams per day. Clinical trials in TD with Austedo BID include two randomized controlled trials, AIM-TD and ARM-TD. Patients who successfully completed ARM-TD or AIM-TD were eligible to enroll in an open-label long-term maintenance study, RIM-TD. Patients in RIM-TD were followed for 3 years. In the ARM-TD study, patients receiving Austedo demonstrated a rapid and significant improvement in AIM's total score. Reductions were seen as early as 2 weeks. Improvement in AIM scores from baseline to week 12 was 3 points for Austedo compared with placebo, which had a 1.6 point reduction. In total, this is a treatment effect or reduction of 1.4 points. The AIM-TD study was consistent with the ARM-TD results, with a reduction in the AIM score of 1.9 points versus placebo. In the RIM-TD open-label study, the average daily dose of Austedo increased from 17 milligrams at week 2 to 36 milligrams at week 6. Starting at week 6, there was a gradual reduction in mean AIM's total scores through week 145. AIM scores decreased by 1.6 points at week 2. By 6 weeks, the point reduction was 3.6. And after 3 years, the average AIMS point reduction was 6.6. The average dose of Austedo at week 145 was about 39 milligrams per day. Overall, 67% of patients achieved greater than or equal to 50% improvement in AIMS total score at the end of the 3-year study. Most patients and physicians reported symptoms as much improved or very much improved on assessments of the clinical global impression of change and patient global impression of change. While TD symptoms improved, pre-existing psychiatric scores remained stable. Compliance was about 90% at 3 years. The most common adverse reactions for Austedo, 3% and greater than placebo in controlled clinical studies in patients with TD, were nasopharyngitis and insomnia. Adverse events in the 3-year study were comparable to those in the 12-week clinical trials. Once patients were titrated to their maintenance dose in AIM-TD, dry mouth, nausea, and hypertension were no longer reported. And in ARM-TD, somnolence and dry mouth both improved during maintenance. Austedo XR is a one-pill, once-daily treatment option that provides flexibility for effective and tolerable symptom control. The recommended starting dosage of Austedo XR for patients with TD is 12 milligrams per day. Continue titrating by 6 milligrams per day each week until symptom control is effectively and tolerably achieved, or the maximum recommended daily dose of 48 milligrams is reached. The average daily dose in clinical trials was greater than 36 milligrams. At week 145 in RIM-TD, over half of patients received a dose between 36 and 48 milligrams per day. Once daily, Austedo XR should be swallowed whole and may be taken with or without food. A 4-week titration kit is available through sample or prescription to help patients get started on once daily Austedo XR. The titration kit was evaluated in the START study, a phase 4 non-interventional 2-cohort real-world study in patients with TD and Huntington's disease. In START, a majority of patients reached 24 milligrams per day or higher by week 4, and greater than 90% of patients were adherent to the titration kit. For patients currently on Austedo BID, transitioning to once daily Austedo XR is straightforward. Simply write once daily Austedo XR for their next refill at the same total daily dose as Austedo BID. I talk to my patients about what to expect while taking Austedo XR and how important it is to stay on the medication at the dose prescribed. I base my discussion on the outcomes from RIM-TD, and let my patients know that we will be assessing progress at each appointment with the AIMS. Now we will look at Charlene's experience. She is 65 years old and is being treated with APDs for schizoaffective disorder. Before treatment for her TD, she has constant movement in her face, hands, and feet, and appears to be rocking in her chair. Charlene started taking AUSTEDO and noticed improvements in her movement as her dose was titrated. Now, after taking AUSTEDO for over 2 years, Charlene is very pleased with her results. She notes that her hands and feet aren't moving all the time. After being titrated to the maximum dose of 48 milligrams per day, she notes that she can do things that other people consider normal, like tying her shoes. Notice that before treatment, she was wearing slip-on shoes, but after, she was wearing laced sneakers. I'd like to walk you through how her dose was titrated over time. When she developed TD, she was initially told her involuntary movements would last forever. This was before the advent of VMAT2 inhibitors. Eventually, she was prescribed AUSTEDO 12 milligrams per day after this video was recorded. In this video, Charlene is taking AUSTEDO 24 milligrams per day. The rocking has stopped, but her AIMS total score is 4, and we can still see movements in her face and occasionally in her hands. At this point, the conversation is between the healthcare provider and patient to make the shared decision of whether to increase the dose. Charlene was interested in trying to continue reducing her abnormal movements. We see additional improvement when her dose is increased to 36 milligrams per day. Charlene notes her mouth stopped moving. We can see some involuntary blinking and her fingers moving just a bit. Now at 48 milligrams per day, Charlene has additional reduction in her movements. It's great to see her smiling here. She would like to keep taking AUSTEDO long-term. AUSTEDO XR helps reduce TD symptoms without having to modify the patient's antipsychotic dose. Monitor your patients closely over time to ensure you have them on an appropriate dose of AUSTEDO XR to give them the best chance for success. Thank you for making the time to watch my presentation today. I hope you will find it valuable and useful in your clinical practice.
AUSTEDO XR, deutetrabenazine extended release tablets, and AUSTEDO, deutetrabenazine tablets, are indicated in adults for the treatment of chorea associated with Huntington's disease and for the treatment of tardive dyskinesia. AUSTEDO XR and AUSTEDO can increase the risk of depression and suicidal thoughts and behavior, suicidality, in patients with Huntington's disease. Balance the risks of depression and suicidality with the clinical need for treatment of chorea. Closely monitor patients for the emergence or worsening of depression, suicidality, or unusual changes in behavior. Inform patients, their caregivers, and families of the risk of depression and suicidality and instruct them to report behaviors of concern promptly to the treating physician. Exercise caution when treating patients with a history of depression or prior suicide attempts or ideation. AUSTEDO XR and AUSTEDO are contraindicated in patients who are suicidal and in patients with untreated or inadequately treated depression. AUSTEDO XR and AUSTEDO are contraindicated in patients with Huntington's disease who are suicidal or have untreated or inadequately treated depression. AUSTEDO XR and AUSTEDO are also contraindicated in patients with hepatic impairment, patients taking reserpine, or within 20 days of discontinuing reserpine, patients taking monoamine oxidase inhibitors, MAOIs, or within 14 days of discontinuing MAOI therapy, and patients taking tetrabenazine or valbenazine. Clinical worsening and adverse events in patients with Huntington's disease. AUSTEDO XR and AUSTEDO may cause a worsening in mood, cognition, rigidity, and functional capacity. Prescribers should periodically reevaluate the need for AUSTEDO XR or AUSTEDO in their patients by assessing the effect on chorea and possible adverse effects. AUSTEDO XR and AUSTEDO may prolong the QT interval, but the degree of QT prolongation is not clinically significant when AUSTEDO XR or AUSTEDO is administered within the recommended dosage range. AUSTEDO XR and AUSTEDO should be avoided in patients with congenital long QT syndrome and in patients with a history of cardiac arrhythmias. Neuroleptic malignant syndrome, NMS, a potentially fatal symptom complex reported in association with drugs that reduce dopaminergic transmission, has been observed in patients receiving tetrabenazine. The risk may be increased by concomitant use of dopamine antagonists or antipsychotics. The management of NMS should include immediate discontinuation of AUSTEDO XR and AUSTEDO, intensive symptomatic treatment and medical monitoring, and treatment of any concomitant serious medical problems. AUSTEDO XR and AUSTEDO may increase the risk of akathisia, agitation, and restlessness. The risk of akathisia may be increased by concomitant use of dopamine antagonists or antipsychotics. If a patient develops akathisia, the AUSTEDO XR or AUSTEDO dose should be reduced. Some patients may require discontinuation of therapy. AUSTEDO XR and AUSTEDO may cause Parkinsonism in patients with Huntington's disease or tardive dyskinesia. Parkinsonism has also been observed with other VMAT2 inhibitors. The risk of Parkinsonism may be increased by concomitant use of dopamine antagonists or antipsychotics. If a patient develops Parkinsonism, the AUSTEDO XR or AUSTEDO dose should be reduced. Some patients may require discontinuation of therapy. Sedation is a common dose-limiting adverse reaction of AUSTEDO XR and AUSTEDO. Patients should not perform activities requiring mental alertness, such as operating a motor vehicle or hazardous machinery, until they are on a maintenance dose of AUSTEDO XR or AUSTEDO and know how the drug affects them. Concomitant use of alcohol or other sedating drugs may have additive effects and worsen sedation and somnolence. Tetrabenazine elevates serum prolactin concentrations in humans. If there is a clinical suspicion of symptomatic hyperprolactinemia, appropriate laboratory testing should be done and consideration should be given to discontinuation of AUSTEDO XR and AUSTEDO. Do tetrabenazine or its metabolites bind to melanin-containing tissues and could accumulate in these tissues over time? Prescribers should be aware of the possibility of long-term ophthalmologic effects. The most common adverse reactions for AUSTEDO, greater than 8% and greater than placebo, in a controlled clinical study in patients with Huntington's disease were somnolence, diarrhea, dry mouth, and fatigue. The most common adverse reactions for AUSTEDO, 4% and greater than placebo, in controlled clinical studies in patients with tardive dyskinesia, were nasopharyngitis and insomnia. Adverse reactions with AUSTEDO XR extended-release tablets are expected to be similar to AUSTEDO tablets. Please see full prescribing information, including boxed warning, at AUSTEDOHCP.com.